A stunning GOP win in Massachusetts, and it's not just the independent voters feeling stung. David Sirota, a political columnist and author of The Uprising and Unauthorized Tour of the Populist Revolt, Scaring Wall Street and Washington, joining me live from Denver. David, good to see you. Thanks for the time. Let's start at the top here. I want to play for you President Obama's take on what's happening, what happened in Massachusetts and what's happening nationally, and then I want your thoughts on it.
Certainly, I think a lot of us were surprised about where this was going about a week ago. Here's my assessment of not just the vote in Massachusetts, but the mood around the country. You know, the same thing that swept Scott Brown into office swept me into office. People are angry and they're frustrated.
Well, David, does the president have it right there?
He's got it exactly right. Where he's got it wrong is that that it's his constituency, it's his administration, it's his policies that are making people angry. And I say that as somebody who supported President Obama's election. I mean, what I think is going on here is that in 2008, you had a country that was very angry at a government that seemed to be listening to big money corporate interests, powerful interests in Washington, and you had a candidate, President Obama, or candidate Obama, who ran against that. Unfortunately, what you've gotten in the first year of the president, Obama, are policies that have basically tried to coddle those corporate interests, basically tried to appease those corporate interests. So you get Wall Street bailouts. You get a health care bill that would give away $1 trillion to the private drug insurance.
David, I got
to
stop you. What is it that, these groups, Democrats and independents, would have had the president do in the face of what was being described as a potential collapse of the economic system in this country?
I'll tell you what they would have had him do. They would have had him put in place serious strings on the bailouts. They would have had him at least, at the very minimum, ask for transparency. I mean, Tony, look at what we've gotten in the last couple of months, right? We've gotten these bailouts that are subsidizing massive executive bonuses. The administration could have stopped those bonuses. We've gotten a situation where the administration is still hiding emails from AIG to tell us just what happened. So those are just two examples of just the most minimal things that this administration
could have done. So if you then come back and say, you know what, we're going to levy this fee, we're going to make sure you, the taxpayer, get all of your money back, it just seems to me you don't get much credit for averting the disaster.
Well, I mean, the part of the problem is that the disaster was created in part by both Democrats and Republicans.
Yes.
Who deregulated the economy. So there's that problem. Look, I think the public wants a government right now and political representatives who feel as angry as they are at the institutions and corporations that created the problems we face. That's both Wall Street and that's the health insurance bill. I mean, let's talk about the health insurance bill here, right? The bill, the Senate version of the bill, is a huge giveaway to the drug and insurance companies that are part of, a big part of what got us to a healthcare crisis.
You talk about Democrats. Let's stay on healthcare for a moment. That the Democrats are embarrassed by their leadership on healthcare. Explain the embarrassment.
Well, I think Democratic voters are saying, look, you made all sorts of sweeping promises about what you would try to do, you, the Obama administration. You would try to pass a public option. And I think what people are feeling humiliated by, Democratic voters, is that they're now begging their elected officials, Democratic elected officials, to just give it the good old college try. I mean, let's not forget, Tony, the public option, just as one example. The Senate did not even have a floor vote on this. President Obama went back and forth on whether to create a public option. That's the most minimal shred of health care reform that he kind of promised. And the fact is, they have not even made a good try. It'd be one thing if he tried and failed, but I think people are saying, you're not even trying.
All right, David Sirota, that's good stuff. Let's have you back and let's talk about this some more. Appreciate it. Thank you, sir.